Now, I put this list together quickly. Didn't take too much time to think about it, and by that I mean 24 hours of research. And
it wasn't like the College Football Playoff Committee.
No, but I had to put a little thought into this because there are a lot of options you can go with, and I have to be able to sort it out.
There's no doubt about it. You want to start at number five there?
Let's start at number five.
Okay. Number five.
I'm going to keep it simple here. Just need something quick, a standard candy bar, some kind of chocolate. I mean, there is a theme with my top five, but there's going to be some chocolate, a little peanut butter in there, some kind of, I don't know, Reese's Pieces peanut butter cup, maybe something simple like M&M's. You need something on the go.
So your number five is a candy bar.
Yeah, just some kind of something small.
That's
nothing
a dessert.
Crazy.
Okay.
It can be for me, yeah.
Okay. Now, I would say I would highly encourage that to be in the freezer. I love a freezer half-frozen candy bar.
Yeah, for sure. Throw a Snickers in there.
Reese's Pieces.
Oh, yeah.
Reese's Peanut Butter Cups, rather. Delicious.
I'd go Reese's Peanut Butter Cup first.
I would agree.
York Peppermint Patty, underrated.
Oh, yeah. Especially half-frozen.
Totally.
Oh, my.
Can't count out Junior Mints, too, although I can't find them anywhere else but a movie theater for $12 a box. After you spend $25 on a ticket, you got to spend $12 on a box of Junior Mints.
All right, number four.
Number four.
Number four, I'm going to go with some kind of chocolate cake, either like a triple-layer blackout cake or...
Blackout
mousse.
Cake.
Oh, there's a blackout cake. It's actually sitting in my fridge at home.
Wow.
And I don't normally share dessert. I have a no sharing dessert policy.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. So there's a full size triple layer chocolate blackout cake from a bakery near where I grew up. And that's chocolate mousse.
What makes it a blackout cake?
I mean, it's literally just layer upon layer of chocolate. You got chocolate frosting, then there's chocolate sprinkles, chocolate chips. I mean, it's pretty dangerous.
And then is the
You don't want to get stuck in a blackout. You don't want to get stuck eating too big pieces of this cake. Yeah.
Is the meat of the cake chocolate cake?
Yeah.
Whoa. So chocolate cake, chocolate icing, chocolate chips, chocolate frosting, chocolate sprinkles.
It's, you name it, it's on
That's
there.
A blackout.
And chocolate mousse is also, I lump those two together because it's a cake of some kind.
You might black out after eating the blackout cake.
It's happened.
Okay.
It's all happened.
Right. Voice guy?
Number three.
Number three, I'm going to go with a brownie sundae.
Again, chocolate is a real
theme
here.
It's a theme. If there's not chocolate, it's not dessert in my world.
So, brownie sundae.
Yeah. Now, you can do your standard brownie sundae with, vanilla or chocolate ice cream and syrup and whipped cream and all that stuff. Or there's Cold Stone Creamery mashes a chocolate brownie into like their mint chocolate chip.
Oh dear.
Yeah. It's heavy.
Do you like Cold Stone ice cream? I find Cold Stone to be a little too doughy of ice cream for me.
It is. I mean, this like mint chocolate chip brownie mix they got going on where they'll literally mash a brownie in front of you and then mix it with the mint chocolate chip ice cream. That's pretty outrageous, but you can't have too much of it.
It's delicious. The only thing is I don't know how you have a dairy product that beads like a cake batter. Like, how is that possible?
It's a lot.
Ice cream, if you tried to mash it together, would just, kind of start melting like dairy would, frozen dairy, but it like pulls apart like taffy.
I feel for the people that work there because it's like you almost need to pass a fitness test to be able to scrape out.
Yeah, it's tough.
And then they're just, they're kneading it down and mashing the brownie in there. Like they're sweating.
Yeah.
They're sweating back.
They've got to have real dexterity and then strong wrists and fingers and forearms.
I know. It's usually people that are training for like Ironman competitions. They do this like during the day as like their, non-workout
activities.
No doubt. Activities.
Yeah, Cold Stone is
for
intense.
For sure, yeah.
Cold Stone is intense.
Number two.
Thank you, voice guy.
Number two, I'm going to go with, this is a conversation we had with Mraz not too long ago. Just a frozen yogurt shop. Take the biggest bowl you can and load it up.
Now, for Mraz, he says you can't have any space in there.
I know. We got a little too much into, geometry. And
yeah, Mraz isn't exactly Neil deGrasse Tyson here. He thinks that you actually pay for the empty space on weight because he thinks that space within frozen custard is weighted, but it's not.
He skipped that semester in geometry.
He's not here today. He's out today, so we couldn't get a validation here. But so I love like a 16 candles, just pound all that frozen yogurt.
Yeah, give me a couple flavors, and then just you go to town on the toppings.
The toppings is where it's at.
It's like art for me. You got to spread it out. You got to get enough of everything. Top it off with some chocolate syrup, and 3 pounds later, you're paying $30 at 16 handles for Ice cream.
Just delicious.
Just delicious.
Number one.
And the number one dessert, according to the dessert coordinator, Brad Heller.
You can never go wrong with a soft chocolate chip cookie.
Oh, wow. So that's basic. So you're going kind of traditional,
basic,
old school.
Basic, soft chocolate chip cookie where maybe the chocolate chips are maybe they're still a little melted in there, maybe a little undercooked.
You know,
in the middle there.
This is like the Penn State uniforms. You know, when we do uniform ranking, if you like traditional and you like simple, you go Penn State. What you're saying is chocolate chip cookie, the number one dessert because it's traditional and simple.
Yeah, give me, the jersey I have at home. The one I cherish is the Derek Jeter pinstripe. You know, just the number two, no name on the back. And this is what the chocolate chip cookie is for me. There's a couple of places in New York City, in Manhattan. We walked by one of them the other day that just do it right. I mean, the big cookies that with the chocolate chips that are a lot of chocolate chips. That don't give me, you know, one or two chips in there. That's
no.
You're shortchanging me.
Yeah, we actually did a Nomad episode on this, on the chocolate chip cookie across the street. I forget the name of this bakery right here, but Mraz called it the greatest chocolate chip cookie he's ever had. It's like the size of his head and his chocolate chunks in there. I mean, it was remarkable. It's the Halloween episode of season one of Nomad, if you want to check that out on YouTube.
Yeah, and then there's another one. There's one by my apartment that does them even bigger. They're like scones. They're thick scone-like.
Thick, yeah.
Yeah. I think you've experienced that, too.
Well, I feel good, and I'm doing well.
And that's the dessert power rankings.